Hello, welcome to Storyboard That. My name is Eric, and today I'm going to show you how to make a plot diagram worksheet using one of Storyboard That's pre-made templates. Let's get started. So first, we're going to choose a template that we like. All right, I'm going to go with this castle one, and all you have to do is click the copy template button that is below. Now this will bring you directly into the Storyboard Creator, where it will prompt you to give your storyboard a title. So let's just call this worksheet number one, and then click continue. All right, now it's time for us to customize our worksheet. This is where we get to add any directions, update the text, add any characters, items, whatever changes we would like. So to start, I'd like to change this background. I like the castle, but it's a little busy. So all you have to do is click on the item. Now you can change the colors in the right-hand menu, but I think it's still a little busy, so let's take it out completely. So to do that, all you have to do is delete the original scene and then add your own. So go up to the scene menu, and let's go over to mythical and futuristic. Now I still like the castle idea, so let's grab this one. All you have to do is drag and drop it into your worksheet, and then click fit to screen. Now let's go with non-proportional. So this will fill it really nicely, and it does stretch the image a little bit, but I don't think it's too noticeable. Then click OK. Now once you have your scene in place, you can send it to the back of the worksheet. Now you can also rotate this image. Now I'd like this little tower to be in between these two text boxes. So what we can try to do is flip the image. You can flip it horizontally. It's still not quite right, so let's slide it over a little bit, and you can actually stretch images. If you grab one of the sides right in the center, and you can stretch it out. Let's slide this over a little bit. All right, I think that works pretty good. Now next is characters. I like these two characters, but I think I want to have a knight in the scene. So let's delete these two and add a knight. So all you have to do is go up to your characters menu and then go down to medieval category. And let's find a knight we like. I like this first one. So all you have to do, like the scene, is just drag and drop it into your worksheet. And now we get to customize our character. This is where we get to add facial expressions, change poses, and make any other physical characteristic changes that we would like. So let's update our knight. Let's have him standing guard and give him a serious expression. And when you are all set updating your character, all you have to do is click update pose. Now you can drag your character anywhere you want in your worksheet. And you can also resize them by dragging the corner of the image. Now his armor does blend into the rocks and the castle. So if we go over to our right-hand menu, we can still make changes, specifically the color. So let's give him a gold suit of armor. All right, next is items. You can browse the items category, and you can also search for items in the upper right-hand search menu. I'd like to give this knight a lance. So lance. All right, great, and let's grab this one. Just drag and drop it into your scene. And I like to have him holding onto it correctly. So let us rotate. Go into your right-hand menu and click rotate twice. And then we can fit this into place. Let's put it about here and bring him up a little bit. All right, I like the lance, but let's change the color to match the castle tops, that red. All right, perfect. Now, last but not least is text box. Now you can edit and make any changes to any of the pre-existing text boxes. All you have to do is click and then put in your own words. So let's just give some general directions of come up with your own story. For this scene. All right, now you can also change your font as well as its size. All you have to do is highlight what you want to change, go over to the text editor, and let's select a new font. All right, this feels very medieval. And let's make that a little bit larger so it fits in the scene well. All right, great. Now you can also add additional text boxes. All you have to do is go up to the speech bubbles menu and choose any one that you would like. Now, just like characters and items, any of the text boxes can be moved and resized. Now, when you're all done with your plot diagram, all you have to do is go down to the bottom right-hand corner of your screen and click the orange save and exit button. And that is how you make a plot diagram using Storyboard That. Thanks for watching and happy storyboarding.